Hey, my name is Marcel. I have a PhD in chemical engineering, and in this video I'm going to show you how to do ANOVA after having performed an experiment. I'm going to do it in Python, but it doesn't really matter because the concepts will be the same no matter which program you use. This is the example we're going to use. It's an experiment where we tested how the four factors temperature, pressure, concentration of formaldehyde and stirring rate affected the filtration rate in a chemical process. We already have visualized the results, and now we would like to use ANOVA to find out which of these factors is actually significant so that we can concentrate our future efforts on these few significant parameters. For example, in a follow-up experiment, or if we need to give a presentation, maybe at a conference or to our boss. So how do we do that? It's actually a quite simple process. First, we define a model. We fit that to our experimental data, perform the ANOVA, compare the p-values of our model parameters, and either delete parameters with a p-value that is greater than 0.05 or add parameters where we think the p-value might be smaller than 0.05. And then we repeat. This is the Python code that does that, and we see exactly the process that I just talked about. We start by defining a model that we then fit to estimate the group means. Then we perform the actual ANOVA, look at the results, and repeat until we have added all the parameters that are significant and removed all parameters that are not. If you're wondering how to get to that code, I am using an AI assistant that helps me write my Python code. Check the link in the video description if you want to try it. Okay, now let's talk about that iteration process and specifically the model building process, how to approach that systematically. There are basically two options to choose from. The first one I call the all parameter model. You start by throwing in all possible main effects and interactions, then step by step remove the least significant parameter, the one with the highest p-value, until you're left with only the significant ones. This can be a little bit tedious depending on the number of factors you have in your experiment. The second one can be faster, and we are also going to use this approach in our example. I call it the stepwise addition model, where you start with known significant parameters, or at least you assume that they might be significant, and from there stepwise add others, checking their significance each time until there are no more significant parameters to add. How do we know which parameters might be significant? Easy, because we have visualized our results beforehand. Here we see that likely the main effects of temperature, stirring rate, and concentration are significant, as well as the temperature stirring rate interaction and the interaction between temperature and concentration. So let's use that as a starting point. And we specify that here within our formula. We have the filtration rate, each main effect, temperature, concentration of formaldehyde, and stirring rate. And then the interactions of temperature and concentration of formaldehyde and temperature and stirring rate. So if we execute the code now, we get the results of the ANOVA printed in the ANOVA table. Let's take a closer look at how to interpret it and what to do with this. First, we have the model terms that we specified, followed by the degrees of freedom. The sum of squares is a measure for the variation due to each factor. The higher it is, the bigger the effect of this factor on the result variable. The mean square is the sum of squares divided by the respective degrees of freedom. And then we have the F value, which is the ratio between explained variance and unexplained variance, or the mean squares of the factor divided by the mean squares of the residuals. The larger this number, the more likely the parameter is significant. And last but not least, and this is actually the most important parameter of all, we have the p-value. It has to do with the f-value, but for simplicity, let's just say that when the p-value is smaller than 0.05, then we keep the model term because it is significant. The 0.05 actually means that there is a 5% chance that the model term is not significant. So in reality, you could also tweak that 0.05 a little bit if you need to. Okay, so if we look at the p-values for all the parameters that we included here, then we see that all of them are actually significant. So let's play around a little bit to see if we find more. And first we can add the pressure back in here. Execute again, and we see that the pressure actually has a p-value of 0.17. So that means it's not significant. So let's take it back out. Now next we could also add, let's say, a three-way interaction here between temperature, RPM, and the concentration of formaldehyde. Look at that, and we see now this p-value is even larger with 0.5. So that's also not a significant parameter. And maybe we also try the concentration of formaldehyde and the steering rate interaction. And we see that this one's also not significant. So we take it back out, and it looks like that is our final model. But wait, we need to check if the model makes sense. So watch this video on model control next, and subscribe if you don't want to miss how to do that in Python.